Good morning to you all. Welcome for another session in the series of creating a Tomcat cluster, application cluster. In the whole series we are going to build this cluster, a Tomcat application cluster, with in front of it an Apache 2 load balancer. The Apache 2 is already built in a former session. It's not yet a load balancer. We will do that in another session. Today I want to install Tomcat on the machine Bloomcool. After installing, this is just a standalone Tomcat installation. I will spare your time and not show you how to do Tomcat on Broccoli, because that's exactly the same process. Every Tomcat installation will be the same. In the next episode we are going to try to configure these two Tomcats to be a cluster, so that they can communicate with each other. And the last thing we can do is configure Apache to be a load balancer. One of the virtual hosts, lb.boss, will be the load balancer. But as said, first we are going to install Tomcat on the Bloomcool. So let's get to it. I'm on a terminal on my local machine, so we first go to the Bloomcool. Like to be root. This because I need I like to run Tomcat within its own with its own user and group, so we have to create them, and I can do that as root. First we make a group, add group. Tomcat seems to be appropriate group name. Okay, that's done. Now we can add a user. User add is cut. User add. It's got some options. You can show them if you don't fill in anything. It shows you a little help. User add. C. Tomcat. Software owner. Tomcat, the group we just created. I need min m for creating the home directory. Min minus s slash bin slash dash. If you don't supply a shell, it will default to sh, which in my opinion is not a very nice shell to work with. So I'm giving here the option bash as login shell. And we want to be call the user Tomcat. Okay, that's done. Let's give him a password. Passwd. That's done. So now we have user. Let's try and see if we can log in as Tomcat on the Bloomcool. You have to type the right password you just configured. Well, that's working. We are Tomcat now. Okay, the following thing we need to do is get a JDK, because Tomcat is a Java web application server which needs to run on a JDK. So we will install download a JDK, and we install Tomcat from Apache. First, we go to the web and try to download a JDK. Web browser. Download JDK. Oh, as a side note, I'm using DuckDuckGo. You can see that here. It's an alternative for Google, and DuckDuckGo claims to not track you at all. So it's a bit more privacy aware. Okay, download JDK. DuckDuckGo sends me to Java SE download, SE downloads. I think this is the newest one. I click download. There you have to accept. Otherwise you get a message that you have to accept. I'm on a Linux x64 machine. I don't want to have the RPM. That's more for Red Hat, a Ubuntu based systems. I have a Debian based system, so I take this one, tar.gz. If you click it, it will ask you to download a file. And I always download here. As you can see here, I have already tried it in preparing this session. I don't have to do it again. I now will say leren in late. Okay, let's see. Now we go to Apache Tomcat, the tomcat.apache.org, to download Tomcat. We want the newest one, Tomcat 8, newest but stable. Again, I will choose for tar.gz because I don't. That's the format I like. As opposed to Oracle, Apache supplies a PGP signature file, MD5 hash of the file we download, and an SHA-1 hash of the file, just to make sure that you are downloading what you are supposed to download and that there is not an attacker in the way or that there is tampered with the file. I will show you in a minute how this works. Download, save, and also here again you can see in the preparation I already did this, so I don't have to do it again. Emulate PGP. This is the PGP signature. We have to download it. Save link as. As you can see, already downloaded. So I don't have to do that again. MD5 and SH1 I will show you in a minute. We are going to use this string to check. And the SHA1 string we are going to use to check. First, let's go to my local machine. Here you can see that we have a JDK, which was downloaded earlier on. We have the Apache Tomcat signature file. And we have an Apache Tomcat download. Oracle don't supply hashes, at least not on this side. So we have to trust that what we are thinking, we are downloading, that we actually download this. Apache is a bit more thorough and give us some options to check. First, let's check MD5 some. Apache Tomcat tar.dg. That is this string and it's ending on AF089. Let's see what the MD5 says. AF089. Of course, actually, you have to compare the whole string, but I have enough confidence that this is the same thing. We can also do the same with SHA1 sum. About Apache Tomcat download. It's a bit longer string hash. It's ending on 654819. Let's check what Apache think it must be. 654819. So I think the whole string is the same. Once again, you probably have to compare the whole string and not just the last six characters. Now the PGP, this is a signature. Here you can download the keys which Apache uses to sign all its releases, software releases, and we can verify whether the string, the Apache, I lost the word, the Apache file is actually signed with one of the keys out of this key string. Okay, that is for me. I use GPG, GNU Privacy Guard, /verify apache.asc, that's the signature file, and this is the file we want to check whether it's signed, if it's a correct sign. We can see it's all in Dutch, so you have to trust me. This a sign of a user with a key 2F6059E7. It's a good sign. It's actually signed by Mark E. D. Thomas. Well, that's to say. The signature file is from Mark E. D. Thomas, but no, I did not trust in GPG. In the Web of Trust, this signature. So I'm still not completely sure, but I hope, and well, that's for some that's blasphemy, but I hope that the keys distributed in the keys file are correct. So I'm, for me, this is enough confidence to be sure that there's not, that this file not is tampered with. In conclusion, I think this Apache Tomcat is okay. As you can see, Apache makes a lot of work in ensuring that you download the right stuff, and I think that that all software vendors or software suppliers should do this way, because it gives some assurance that we are not being hacked, no man in the middle attacks or whatsoever. Okay, now let's get these two files to the target machine. JPG860 to Tomcat at Tomcall. Oh, that's going wrong. I need to let's try like this. Oh, I typed the machine name wrong. It goes quite fast. Then we have to do the same thing with the Apache Tomcat. Okay, there it is. Now I go to the Tomcat again. I'm in this terminal. I am using Tomcat at Bloomcall. You can see the two files are there. First, go about JDK, tar, extract, verbose, compressed file, JDK, there you go. Okay. Okay, here you can see there now is a directory, JDK, JDK, with some subdirectories, a bin directory. I will use this bin directory for as from where the Java will be loaded. cd/bin. And you can see there is here a Java. Everything is in there. Also, there is a Java runtime environment. It's supplied with this download, but I'm going to use /bin. Okay, it's wise to put something in your environment that this Java in the bin directory is the first Java in the path, so that you are sure that this Java will be loaded. I will type pwd. This is the Java home we are going to need, and I will put that in api.rc. It's Debian, so there's a lot of stuff already in it. I say export Java home is right. Export path is $java home / bin colon $ path. So I've prepended the Java home / bin to the path. I will log in once more and say which Java. We see that Java will be searched out of this directory. That's exactly what we want. Okay, that's one. ls / l. We also have the Apache. We will unpack and unzip tar extract from compressed file Apache. There you go. It's not too big, so it's going quite fast. Actually, most of the work is done now for just a normal plain installation. There is already a bin. There is a lib, so everything is in here. We can now see whether we can start this this installation. Of course, it's in the binaries directory. I will go for startup. Startup.sh. Start. Okay. This suggests that Tomcat did actually start. PSEF grep Tom. Yes, there it is. We see a Java process which is running a Tomcat instance. Of course, the proof of the pudding is in the eating, so let's see if we can connect. That's not so smart. Blue call dot boss 1.8080, standard port for Java web applications. I see that I type it wrong again. There we go. Drums, please. Yes, there it is. We have actually on this port 8080, we have a connection. It's serving the default Apache Tomcat page. So, in short, we now have a working Tomcat. Of course, I would like to deploy some things. You will see that I now get an error message, manager app. Well, I don't get the error message, but I don't have a user which I can use. We have to first configure that. Let's go and see if we do something wrong. What happens if we do that a few times? Nothing happens. Okay, there you go. I cancelled and then say you need the role manager GUI. Now this role name must be assigned to the user logging in, and then you can use this web app. That we have to configure first. Not too much of a problem. Back on the machine loom call. To the configuration directory of Tomcat. You see some files. Most important is the server.xml, which all the server, the valves, the engines, the host configuration in it. We get back to that. Well, we can have a look right now, just to see what is supplied. It's of course XML document. You can see that a server is defined, beginning tag, listeners. There's a lot of documentation within this file, which makes it very self-explanatory, but also a bit difficult to read, in my opinion. But you can see there's also the realm. We are going to use user database. You can see the host, which is defined in our where the web apps actually are, but well, we come back to this file in another part in this series. Today we are going to have a look at vi.tomcat.users.xml. this. Don't forget to remove the surrounding comment tags, because you get crazy if you have changed everything and it still don't work and it doesn't work and again it don't work, and then you see that your comment tags were not removed. That's not, well, not so fun. Okay, we need the role of Posit Manager GUI, if I remember correctly. Manager GUI. The username, I call it manager. The password, well, just for now, manager. And the role, it gets one of the roles, manager. Well, first see whether we can get there now right away, or that we have to restart Tomcat. I click manager app. I type manager. Nope. So first we have to restart the engine. Cancel. Bing first shut it down nicely. So it shut down cleanly. Start up. Seems like that worked. Check. Yep, there is a Java process running. Back to this page. There you go. The manager app is working. We can see some deployments. We are now using the manager app. You can actually see one session in it. Host manager is also used frequently. If we click on this one, we get another inlog. Host manager. Manager says manager. The same is not enough. We get error, a warning. We now need the admin GUI role, which we supply also in the same file, of course. Admin GUI via Tomcat users. We create another role. Paste. Admin GUI. And we will role to this user. Of course, then we have to start up and stop again. Confidence that it actually stopped, so I will start it. Enough confidence to check it right away. Host manager does there. Well, there you go. It's there. You can see that there are one host name defined, there are no virtual hosts. Server status. If you look closely, you can see that it's from the manager app, so we are back in the manager app and not the host manager again. List applications. We're there. Done. I think we have done what was spoken for. Today we installed this Tomcat instance on the machine Bloomcool. Next episode we are going to try to make that a cluster. In the meanwhile, I will prepare Tomcat on the broccoli. When I've done that, we are going to make a small video for creating the cluster of these two Tomcat instances. And in a further on in the series, we are going to create a load balancer on vhost lb.boss. Thank you for watching.